Writing asynchronous code involves several aspects that you need to take care of. The asynchrony itself is only one of them. In this video, I will design an asynchronous operation that supports graceful cancellation. So stay with me through the demo and you will learn a few practical tricks about canceling a call to an async method. Imagine there is an operation that interacts with the file system. It might create a text file by writing chunks of text which it generates randomly. The problems become apparent when I try to use this method. This call will block the main thread of execution until all the I/O transfers are over. Consider writing a very large file. The application could become unresponsive for as much as 10 seconds. That is unacceptable. Enter async methods and tasks. Virtually every I/O operation in .NET today, including database and network access, has its asynchronous variant. This call would return a running task, so we must await it here. The ball is in our yard, so the custom method must become async, returning a task. In the blink of an eye, asynchronous execution has propagated all the way to the main execution thread. I have blocked it to wait on the asynchronous task, but I don't have to. I have moved that file-based operation to another class to focus on the main method. That is what the users can actually see, the UI, which may look dead if we don't do something. Here is how we make it responsive. Take the task itself, but not await it. Instead, do the regular UI work here, such as asking the user to enter some data and then acting on that data. I can occasionally check the status of my background task and stop when that work is over. The user could also quit the interaction by ending the input or just pressing enter. I must still await the background task before concluding the entire interactive operation. When I run the application, you can see it is fully responsive. While I talk to it, the other task is slowly writing hundreds of megabytes of random text to the file. Even when I ended the interaction, the process waited until the file-based operation was completed in the background. Still, this implementation lacks two vital elements to be useful. One is the ability to gracefully cancel an asynchronous task without fear of dangling resources or damage to data. The other is receiving feedback from the task about its progress. In this video, I will show you how to cancel an asynchronous task. You can download the entire source code of this demo from my Patreon page. I would kindly ask you to become the sponsor and help me maintain this channel. That will give you access to the source code of more than 100 videos on my channel and help me keep producing more videos like this one. Thank you. Now let's go back to canceling an asynchronous call. I want to separate these two cases. A null return from readline indicates the end of input. I want to cancel the background operation when that happens. Entering an empty line will still wait for the background operation to complete. Tasks in .NET support so-called cancellation tokens. You will have to create one if you wish to cancel a task. That goes by creating a cancellation token source first. You will use this object to signal that you wish some task to terminate gracefully. Just say cancel, that was easy. The ball is now in the task's yard. In one way or another, we must communicate the cancellation token to the asynchronous method. It could be a field in the enclosing class. A more practical approach is to pass it to every call to the asynchronous method. Observe that the async method receives the token, not the token source. Observe also that I am passing the cancellation token as the first argument. You may pass it last after the method's parameters. I have followed the functional convention to list configuration objects first, followed by parameters. That would make this method a tad easier to use from functional C# designs or from F#. Then comes the substance. How do we use a cancellation token within the async method? A critical piece of the puzzle you should never forget is to check which async methods you are calling. They will invariably have an overload accepting the cancellation token. Notice how writeAsync receives the token as the last argument? That is a tradition in BCL. I will not judge you if you judge me for moving it to the front in my method. It is a habit that comes with the functional programming style. Anyway, you have yet to see the proper coding pattern with cancellation tokens. You can occasionally check the cancellation token and let it throw the operation cancelled exception. I don't have to throw myself because the write async method will do that anyway. But I must clean up my resources if the exception pops up to my method. For instance, I might delete the incomplete file. The bonus question for you is, what would happen if this operation threw an IO exception right in the middle of the catch block? Think carefully and don't hesitate to write your thoughts in the comments. Anyway, I must not forget to rethrow the original exception after cleanup. This is the typical coding pattern for an asynchronous operation with resources. Without cleanup, you would not write the try-catch here, and your method would be straightforward. My work here is done. At the calling end, I must take the cancellation token from the token source and pass it to the asynchronous method. But then the cancellation exception remains. All this hard work must stay within a try-finally block, ensuring all resources are cleaned up no matter how we get to the end. It is also a good practice to handle cancellation gracefully. It is not an error, but the result of a decision to cancel. Almost invariably, whoever signals cancellation should stop the propagation of the operation cancelled exception. The cancellation ends here. Let me run the application one last time. I will interact with it once and then cancel further work. Here is confirmation that the operation was cancelled and that the main method cleaned up its garbage in the finally block. It all happened in a blink of an eye. This cancellation was really efficient. Now that you know this, the next stage in your learning could be to figure out how to signal progress back from the asynchronous operation.